We came together to organize this for the body of Christ, for the people of God. You know, you have to put at the back of your mind that the man Jesus is passing by.
Amen.
It is not, it's not about Dr. Eugene or by Prophet Eric, but the man Jesus is doing what? He's passing by. So you have to have the spirit of determination. You have to be in a state of expectancy. A spirit of what? A state of expectancy. Be ready for your miracle. Now, let's deal with this before we continue. Lift up your hands for me. The Bible says in Matthew chapter 10, verse number 36, that the man's enemy shall be those in his what? His own household. There are, as I said yesterday, there are principalities, there are demons in our family. And those spirits pull us back. Those spirits, anytime you are going forward, they come, they hold you and they pull you back. Say, Lord Jesus,
Lord Jesus,
tonight,
tonight,
any spirit,
any spirit,
any power,
any
principality,
any principality
in my family,
any barrier,
any barrier
initiated,
orchestrated
in front of me,
against my finances,
against my marriage,
against my children.
Say tonight,
as I clap my hands and tap my feet, let fire fall on them. Clap your hands and pray. Yes, I got fire. Pray. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. There are two angels working on her. She is free. Put your hands together for Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Amen. God bless you for coming. We are believing God for greater and mighty things. Amen.
Amen.
I believe, as I say, it is not the dream of man. You know, Jesus is passing by. What we have to do is to, we are all going to present our case unto Him. And I believe with power and with prayer, God is going to show Himself up. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, if you have your Bible, open with me to the book of 2 Kings, chapter number 2. 2 Kings. Our God is a good God. Our God is what? Good God. Okay, if you are there, you can read for us. 2 Kings chapter number 2, verse 1. If you are there, you can go. Somebody should read for me.
And it came to pass when the Lord was about to take up Elijah into heaven by a whirlwind.
Okay.
That Elijah went in with Elisha.
The Bible says that, and it came to pass when the Lord was about to take Elijah to heaven, in the way it went. The Bible says that, and Elijah and Elisha started a journey from Gilgal. Shall they say Gilgal?
Yeah.
I am preaching or talking about a topic that I've entitled "The Journey for the Power and the Mantle." Say the journey for the power and the mantle. I'm teaching you, so you have to follow me. You have to be a good student. Say the journey for the power and the mantle.
The journey for the power and the mantle.
So the Bible says that they started the journey in Gilgal. Gilgal means a place of separation. Gilgal means what? A place of separation. Now, when you come to Christ, when you become a Christian, it's a big journey. The first thing that you have to do is to sanctify yourself. Cleanse yourself as a Christian. So the things you used to do, you do them no more. The place you used to go, you go that place no more. You know what? The things you used to do, you do it no more. Say no more.
No more.
Oh, shout and say no more.
No more.
Oh, shout and say no more.
No more.
So the journey, the first thing you do is to separate yourself. Sanctify yourself. So there are some kinds of friends that you used to have, but when you come to the Lord, you have to separate yourself from them. Are you with me, somebody?
Yes.
You know, some of us, our problem is, though you have become a Christian, but you always move with on worldly people. Mm-hmm. You are a Christian, but you always move with people who are not Christian. Mm-hmm. And there are times, some places, it is not meant for you to stay there or go there. Are you with me, somebody?
Yes.
The Bible says that they started the journey from Gilgal, meaning a place of separation. Mm. A place of what? Separation. Okay, can you continue?
Then Elijah said to Elisha, "Stay here, please, for the Lord has sent me unto Bethel."
Now, as a matter of fact, you all know the story of a great man of God called Elijah, having a servant called Elisha. Now, Elisha, according to theologians, Elisha was even older than Elijah. This young man, all that he had, he went to sell his belongings and everything to follow this man. And some friends and some people around could be even relatives and family members were saying, "Why are you wasting your time on this man? Why are you doing this?" As a matter of fact, he said, "No, I know what I'm pursuing." So he dedicated his life, all the days of his life,
to follow this man. Are you with me, somebody?
Yes.
Now, it came to pass where God wanted to come and take Elijah away. And Elisha said, my son, I want you to stay here. I want you to be stay at Gilgal. I said, Papa, why can I leave you? You know, where? Job said, where can we leave your presence? Oh, are you with me, somebody?
Mm.
You know, there are times some of us, when we face persecution, when we pass through trials in life, there are times we want to leave the Lord. There are times when the storms of life begin to hit you, there are times you want to give up. There are times you want to leave the presence of God. David said the other day, he said, how can I leave the presence of God? How can I? The Bible says the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run to it and they are saved.
Yes.
There is no better place. Tell the person behind you, there is no better place.
Or
push him well and say, my sister, there is no better place.
There is no better place.
There is no better place. So the Bible said they left Gilgal and they came to Bethel. Bethel is a place of determination. Now, in the journey of Christianity, ladies and gentlemen, it's about determination. If you don't have determination, you can never go far. You have to have the spirit of determination. That is where the man of God was saying about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. They said, even if our God will not save us, we will never bow before this hall. Even if our God will not save us, we will never. You have to come to a conclusion where you say to yourself, even if I don't have money, even if I don't have transportation, even if I don't have this, I don't have that, I will still serve the Lord. The other day, Joshua said, if you people will not serve the Lord, he said, me and my family, we shall serve the Lord. God is looking for a generation and a kind of people, irrespective of their circumstances, irrespective of their persecutions, irrespective of the things they are passing through, they will stand for God, they will mount up for God, they will cry for God, they will shout for God. If you believe it, shout and say, I believe.
Say determination.
Yes.
You have to have the spirit of determination. Strong. Whether good times or bad times. Stand for God. Say stand for God.
Stand for God.
So the Bible says that they went to Bethel. Continue. Quick.
But Elisha said, as the Lord lives and as your soul lives, I will not leave you.
Continue.
So they went down to Bethel.
Continue.
Now the sons of the prophets who were at Bethel came out to Elisha and said to him, do you know that the Lord will take away your master from over you today?
Mm-hmm.
And he said, yes, I know.
Yes, I know. The Bible says, wait, there were some group of prophets. They came to the Elisha. He said, you know what? Do you know that the Lord is about to take your master? He said, yes, I know. Our problem is we don't know who you are. Some of you don't even know who you are. You don't know the kind of God you are serving. That is why there are times the enemy take advantage. But if you know that you are serving this, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Oh. Some of you, if Stephen Harper comes here now and promise you tomorrow he's going to give you $2 million, I don't know. But some of you will even not sleep. Jehovah God is promising you. I declare by the volumes and the oil in this house, in our mother's life, I declare by the power of God, a year by this time, some of you are going to wealth $5 billion. If you believe, shout as I believe. No, I want you to stand up and shout and say, I receive. I declare by 3 months' time, somebody is going to have $1 million. If you believe, shout and say, I believe. Hallelujah. Money. It comes to money.
What's the rule?
God is good.
Hallelujah.
Oh my God.
Thank you.
Lord, you have a seat. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God, tonight I'm going to pray for you. Some of you have the testimony. After the testimony, call the man of God and tell him. God is going to open a door for some of you where, as you believe, I'm going to stand here as a prophet of God. I'm going to declare that God should do spiritual transfer for you. You know, I quote this quotation. It says, the wealth of the wicked shall be given to the righteous. You know, one of these days, God is going to surprise you. By the time you find yourself, your house will be close to the president and those prime ministers, your house, and some people will come to you, who are you? And you're going to tell, I am a son of God. Oh, are you with me, somebody?
Yes.
Oh, put your hands together for Jesus. This is what God is going to do to your life. They will be thinking you are a doctor. They will be thinking you are that. They will be thinking you are a prime minister. Oh my God, that is the will of God. By the time they come to themselves, and they will know that you are serving a living God.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, continue for me. The Bible said there were a group of prophets. They came to Elisha. He said, do you know that the Lord is about to take your master? He said, yes, I know. You have to know who you are. You have to know who you are. Continue.
Then Elijah said to him, Elisha, stay here, please. For the Lord has sent me on to Jericho.
He said, stay here for me. Stay here, please. His master's key keep on saying, he says, stay here, please. The Lord has sent me to Jericho. Jericho in the in a Christian life means it's a place of the chamber. A place of what? Chamber. Say a place of chamber.
Chambers.
A place of chambers is a place where you go into your corridors and you chamber with God, you browse with God. Some of you spend too much time browsing useless things and talking to useless people. And it's about time for you to go to God. David said the other day, he said, I lifted my eyes onto the mountains, hence that my help come from. No man can help you on this earth. The only person that can help you is Jehovah Jireh.
Yes, amen.
Browse with God. Communicate with God. Talk to God.
Yes.
Talk to God.
Jesus.
Present your case unto God.
Thank you,
and he will answer you.
Yes.
And he will answer you.
Amen.
So Jericho is a place of chamber. It's a place you get time for God. It's a place you get time for God. Who told you that you cannot be a billionaire and still be a Christian? Who told you? You don't know. One day I met a man, a governor. Hey, the man is so influential. You be sitting with him, very simple man, and can call Obama. I was shocked. There was a time he can call president, very influential, very powerful. He told me, prophet, he's so blessed. He's a prophet. I carry some anointing. And when I saw that, I tapped into the anointing. He said, I carry the money magnet anointing. Yesterday, I was talking about the money magnet anointing. Some of you don't understand. You know? And this man is a crazy giver. He's a crazy giver. Even you, there was a time I said, Papa, let me sow seed in your life. Because anytime you visit him, men of God, he sponsors different men of God for different countries. Anytime he have an encounter with you, by the time he speaks to you, you have to release about $1,000 on your feet. You know, sometimes we're a group of pastors, prophets will be going there, and immediately he comes, he'll enter into his corridors. By the time he comes down to talk to us, say, man of God, sometimes some of them, he doesn't even know them. Say, how are you, man of God? Wah, 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 wah. God bless you. Wah, wah, wah. God bless you. Oh, are you with somebody? Oh, are you here with me, somebody?
Yes.
And I was wondering. So there was a time I was, what is this? You know, I was like, this man, what is his secret? And by the time we'll be talking to him, by the time we realize, you enter into a certain small court he has created. Zikapa, shikapa, zikapa, labra, zikapa. With this influence, with this money, pray like that. The kind of tongues this man blow, I was shocked. Put your hands together for Jesus. This kind of tongue supposed to be for Dr. Eugene and me. The man was praying that tongues. So with this influence, you know, that time I went there with a certain Ghanaian, you know, he was a star, he's a Ghanaian actor. And then he told me, we used to go to the mountains together. I said, Prophet Eric, we have to pray more. And I said, Charlie, we have to pray more. Oh, I would be somebody.
Yes.
He said, we have to pray more. Then I said, you cry, you are star. In Ghana, everybody know you. I mean, Charlie. Oh, I would be somebody.
Yes.
We have to pray more. I hope you know Apostle Pratt. Apostle Pratt, yeah, that's a movie. I went with him. We said, Prophet, we have to pray more. With this influence, and this man is praying like crazy. You know, ladies and gentlemen, we are living in a world where you have to understand that the only person that can help you is God.
Mm.
And you have to put at the back of your mind that God can help you.
Yes.
God can do what?
Help you.
So I believe.
I believe.
Continue quick, and then we're going to pray quick. Please.
But he said, as the Lord lives and as your soul lives, I will leave you. So he came to Jericho.
Mm-hmm.
Now the son of the prophet who were at Jericho came to Elisha and said to him, do you know that the Lord has taken your master from over you today?
You see, the same people came to him again. You see, anytime you're about to go to another level, there will be always opposition. I said this yesterday, that oppositions in life, they are like leather, helping you to climb up. If you don't face it, you can never go far. Some of you are afraid of problems. Some of you are afraid of persecution. It is there for you to go far. The Bible says the more they oppress them, the more they increase. Shout and say, I believe.
I believe.
Oh, shout and say, I believe.
I believe.
Continue quick. Go to pray.
So he answered, yes, I know. Keep silent.
Mm-hmm.
And Elijah said to him, stay here, please, for the Lord has sent me out Jordan.
Mm-hmm. Jordan is a place of action. It is about time, ladies and gentlemen. Some of you, you've been praying for so many years. And you've been believing God for bigger miracles. But you are staying home. A time has come that you have to enter into the kind of house you are looking for. The kind of cars you are looking for. There are times just go there and say, you know what? I want to buy this car. And then, you know, you don't have nothing. But I say, I want you people to, I want to test the engine. I want to see. And then when you're going there, dress nice, eh? Present. There are times when they look at you and say, you think you can drive this car? Present yourself as a daughter of God. A daughter of Zion. Even though you don't have nothing, but you dress nice. And then you go to them. Let me tell you, after them driving you out for about 3 hours, you say, this car. No, when you do a new model, I mean, this car is so old. Put your hands together for Jesus. My wife is a typical girl, yeah. And she's always afraid of things. There are times you enter into a nice shop, a very expensive one, and I'll go there boldly. I'll enter inside. They say, hey, where are you going? Huh? You know, you know. They say, come on, shut up, come on. They say, ah, what? I say, they won't do you nothing. Come on, come on. You see, where she's coming from? Our mentality. There are some stores black people don't enter. They are afraid because they don't know. I declare in your life, you shall go there, you shall go there, you shall go there, you shall be there. Shout and say, I believe.
God is good.
Wow. Jordan is a place of action. It is about time for you to, you know, there's one lady, she was believing God for her husband. And what she did was, you know, he went to buy, he called him a prophet. You know, I've been believing God for this. I said, no, I gave him the rationale. Go and buy a coat. Go and buy a sheet. Go and buy a shoe. Everything. Make, you know, like a man. Look at the size. Look at any size that you think you, the kind of man you are looking for. He said, prophet, no problem. He went to buy the thing. Put the thing in his, what do you call it? Or to put. Anytime he said, darling, I'm waiting for you. You have to be. Are you with me, somebody?
Yes.
So anytime he's praying, you come by and say, I'm waiting for you. My time is going. By the time that sister came to her sense, about 4 months, she had a very big, massive wedding.
Wow.
Oh, are you with me, somebody?
Yes.
Some of you, no, I don't know what you are pursuing. I don't know what you are believing God for. But you have to make an action.
Amen.
Some of you, you're looking for big money. You have to start writing a big check. You have to start writing it. You have to go to big companies, talk to people. Tell them, oh my God, things are happening. The other day, Paul said, even if I boast in the Lord.
Yes.
If you're boasting, boast in the Lord.
Yes.
Declare big things.
Yes.
Declare what?
Big things.
Tell people, you know, by next year, sometime when I'm moving with my wife, I'll be telling her, you know, we see all these houses. By 6 months, I'm going to buy all these houses and
Amen.
I'm going to rent it into those people. These people are going to leave this place.
Yes.
They'll be looking at my face. I'm like, okay. Positive confession. One thing I believe, I love about Nigerians. Yeah. God bless you. Nigerians are very aggressive when it comes to things.
That's
right. That is true. Anything they do, you say, Pastor,
yeah.
Doctor. They are aggressive, even ministry. I love them. I always want to connect with them. They are aggressive. The way I preach and the way I talk, you see my tonation is like a Nigerian. I move with a lot of Nigerians. Everything they do it aggressively. I declare that with that, God is going to open the showers of heaven on your behalf. If you believe, shout and say, I believe.
Amen.
Continue.
But he said, as the Lord lives and as your soul lives, I will not leave you. So the two of them went on. And 50 men of the sons of the prophets went and stood facing them at a distance, while the two of them stood by the Jordan. Now Elijah took his mantle, rolled it up, and struck the water. And it was divided this way and that, so that the two of them crossed over on dry ground. And so it was, when they had crossed over, that Elijah said to Elisha, "Ask, what may I do for you before I am taken away from you?" Elisha said, "Please let a double portion of your spirit be upon me." So he said, "You have asked a hard thing."
You have asked a hard thing. Some of you, he said, you have asked of what? A hard thing. Some of you, you are even afraid to ask. When you're asking, ask a bigger thing. He said, "Papa, I need a double portion of your anointing." Say, "Double portion."
Double portion.
Oh, shout, they say, "Double portion."
Double portion.
Elijah said, "When I am going, be alert, be ready." The other version says, he says, "When I am see when say when I'm going means see me go. See me go means follow me." Say, "Follow me."
Follow me.
You see, if you see an anointing, like the anointing upon my brother, and you like it, you follow, you tap into the anointing. Amen. When you see a kind of grace, you tap into it, follow it, and you're going to have it. Mm-hmm. Amino.
Amen.
Continue.
You have asked a hard thing. Nevertheless, if you see me when I am taken away from you, it shall be so for you. But if not, it shall not be so.
Mm-hmm.
Then it happened, as they continued on and talked, that suddenly a chariot of fire appeared with horses of fire and separated the two of them. And Elijah went up by a whirlwind into heaven. And Elisha saw it, and he cried out, "My father, my father, the chariot of Israel and its horsemen." So he saw him no more, and he took hold of his own clothes and tore them into two pieces. He also took up the mantle of Elijah that had fallen from him, and went back and stood by the bank of the Jordan. Then he took the mantle of Elijah that had fallen from him, and struck the water and said, "Where is the Lord God of Elijah?" And when he also had struck the water, it was divided this way and that, and Elisha crossed over. Now when the sons of the prophets, who were from Jericho, saw him, they said, "The spirit of Elijah rests on Elisha." And they came to meet him and bowed to the ground for him.
And they came to meet him and that, they did what?
Bow.
Those people were saying, "Why are you following that man? Why are you wasting your time? Why are you wasting your money?" They all came and said, they all bowed. "I declare over your life, all your enemies, they shall bow in the name of Jesus." I said, "They shall bow in the name of Jesus. They shall bow. They shall bow. Those that are looking for your downfall, they shall bow. They shall bow." Don't worry too much. Don't worry. When you have the testimony, when you have the miracle, that same doctor who said, you can't have a child. I presented my child, and then he was looking at the child, smiling. He said, then he looked at my face, said, "Wow, this is so nice." He couldn't say nothing. That same person was refuting and telling me, "You know, we can't do nothing about this unless we put this thing there." I said, "What are you talking about? I am serving a living God." Shout this, "I believe."
I believe.
Let me tell you. Don't worry too much. Don't talk too much. When the testimony comes, the testimony will speak for itself.
Yeah.
Your perfume will even speak for itself.
Yeah.
Your environment will speak for you.
Yeah.
Your dog will be blessed.
Yeah.
Everything around you will be blessed. Yeah. Shout and say, "I believe, I believe, I believe." Be on your feet, be on your feet, be on your feet now. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Begin to appreciate God. Begin to honor God. Begin to pray. Begin to pray. La baza kapa shaka ba. La pashi kapa zanda brashi. Kuriana. Parashi kapa. Kapa zanda brashi kapa. Nabraska kuriana. Ya kapa shi nabraska nene. Nabarashi nabraska nene. La capa, 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 la capa,